Klappe die sechste. So today it's officially our last class from the spinning techniques. And today we're going to talk about rotisserie turns or also called horizontal turns, or before they have been called roasted chicken. And I will show you why in a second. But nowadays we don't really call it roasted chicken anymore, because obviously us followers, we don't want to be roasted chickens. But I'm going to tell you why it's called like this. So a roasted chicken is typically this movement or a rotisserie turn where we keep our axis with our head and then we turn around the axis with our bodies. And that's why the movement was called roasted chicken. And I sometimes like to use the metaphor just because sometimes it's easier to imagine. Who of you, you can give me maybe a thumbs up or down, did you ever do any class about this movement or never before? Both is fine, both completely fine. Natalia, did you ever do any roasted chicken class before?
Sorry, not yet. I didn't have enough time to check the last video, sorry.
No worries. It's not even in the last week we did something completely different. But did you ever do any of maybe this movement or any?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Very good. Okay. Because this way I can just know how fast I can go ahead or not. Perfect. Then let's start with a warm up, especially for the neck and for the thoracic spine. So this part of our bodies. And then we will start talking about the movement and about the spinning techniques for this movement. Let me put some music. Okay, you can hear the music a little bit and you can hear my voice, yeah? Nice, sehr gut. Okay. Let's start by rolling our shoulders back. Let's only move one shoulder. The one that's not moving, try to really press it down. So I'm pressing my left shoulder down and my right shoulder is circling around. Let's switch up sides. One shoulder is circling, the other is pressed firmly down. Okay, then let's move our chest front and back. Open and close. Without moving the shoulders too much. So today is a little bit focused less on our ankles and a little bit more on our upper body, just because the movement is a little bit harder, or, well, I don't want to say harder, but our upper body has to work a bit more. Okay, let's do one differentiation here. I want you to first move your chest straight front and back, straight. And now let's do something else. Now I want you to open your chest up and back. Diagonal, up and back. Up and back. Okay, let's now switch. We go up and back and front and back. Up and back. Front and back, diagonal and plane, diagonal and plane. Okay, next movement. I want you to take out your arms just to warm up the shoulders, and we go to one side and another side. Let's keep our arms from pointing finger, from index finger to index finger. Let's keep them in one line. Almost done. Keep it up. Okay, relax the arms and let's go all four directions. So we go front, side, back, side. Yeah. Try to make the movement as big as possible without moving the hips. Okay, let's move in circles. Try to make the movement as small as you need it to be, so your hips are not moving, and as big as it can be without the hips moving. Try to find that sweet spot. If you want, you can connect your hands to your hips. So this way you will feel if your hips are moving or not, and you can isolate your upper body a little bit better. Okay, now let's make the movement bigger. So we're going to go up to the front, bend the knees back, straight, and bend. Make yourself as big as possible, and back. Tall, and back. So bend, and back. Only back part. And each time I'm going from side to side, I'm opening the chest, going back again. Let's go to the front part. Front only. Front, click. Click. So I'm closing the chest on the side. Big movement. I want it to warm up. And circles again. But this time the other way around. And let's go smaller. Okay, make the movement as small as you need it to be to isolate your upper body from your hips. Okay, let's move a little bit more our neck, okay? I want you to say no. I want you to say look from one side to the other as far as you can, but slowly and controlled. Only head is moving. Okay, let's say yes now. I want you to look up and down. Make sure when you look down to have a big movement to connect your chin to your chest. When you look up, let's do a smaller movement. We're just warming up. Down big, up small, just to get warm. Porque se depender de mim, tu sempre serás a minha fofa. Okay, very good. Let's do the puppy in love. So I want you to connect one shoulder and one ear. Ear to shoulder, ear to shoulder. So this is not a Zouk movement. We're just actually moving our neck. We're warming up our neck. Normally we would tilt our shoulder line. Right now I keep my shoulder line straight. Just for warm up. Okay, let's do this movement a little bit slower. Now I want you to start to tilt your upper body as well. So I'm tilting from the chair. And now let's imagine first you're opening your rib cage. Then let's imagine you have a wall here, okay? Rib cage first, shoulder, and then the head is going. Ribcage, shoulder, head. Ribcage, shoulder, head, and side. So your head is super lazy. The head is the last thing to go. Okay, stop on one side. Let's just check a little bit our technique here. Let's make sure on your long side you still have a little bit of tension, and on the shorter side I still have space between my ear and my shoulder. So not like this, I have space. Up right again, other side, tension and space. Switch side and switch side. And now I want to do another exercise. A lot of exercises today, as usual. Let's try to go up and down. Let's stay tilted, so I'm not going out of the tilt. I'm just changing the axis from which I'm tilting. So if I go down, I'm tilting from here, more or less where my top is. When I go a little bit more up, I'm tilting more or less from my bra line. This is what we want. So we go down and up, because now we're going out of our axis, in our axis. Out of axis, in our axis. Last time. Let's change sides. In the axis and out of it. I'm staying tilted the whole time. And I love this song very much. It's so hard for me not to sing along. Looks very nice. Okay, let's relax this part. Let's look at our extension and contraction now. Let's go into our contraction. I want you to bend your knees and bring the chest in. This is our contraction. Let me take a look. Yes, nice. Lisa, maybe you can stay a little bit more upright. Maybe we can do an exercise. Okay, let's all do this together. You have your knees just slightly bent. Go into your contraction. And now try to move out of your line. Get back in your line. Out of same exercise as we just did. Out of axis, stay in your axis. So when I'm staying in my axis, my hip is a little bit less bent. And but I'm still contracted, eh? I'm not completely upright. My upper body is round. 5, 6, last time. Okay, now let's go into the extension. Let's just talk quickly about it. Bring your hips into a neutral position. What I want you to do is I want you to breathe in. Open your chest as much as you can. And just one observation before we go here. Just observe my neck quickly. What I don't want you to do, I don't want you to open and put your head here. You see here, I don't have any space. What I want you to do is to elongate your spine and create this space in your neck. Can you see now I have space instead of this? Okay, let's do it together. Breathe in, hips neutral position, a little bit tension in the abdominals, and space in your upper body. Open your chest. Come back. One more time together. Breathe in, open your chest, space for your neck, and come back. Very good. Okay. Very good. Something different today, eh? Today we're not warming up so much our ankles and stuff, just to switch things up. Any questions until here with the technique? No. Okay. Now let's go ahead. I think all of you know how to do circular head movements. So let's do maybe together 2 or 3 circular head movements just to get into the vibe and observe what we do. Let's start like this. I'm going to bring my back towards you. We're going together, breathe in, left, front, and circular, okay? 7, 8, breathe in, and back left. Contraction, tilt right, extension, tilt left, contraction, tilt right, extension, left, contraction, and stop on your right. Let's switch sides. So we go and contraction and left and back and right and contraction and left and back and right. Last time and left and back and right. Contraction, roll up. Yes. Is this fine for everyone until here? Questions? No? Okay, good, good. So I don't know if anyone told you yet, but one of my newest revelations, I think 2 years ago, about rotisserie turns was that actually rotisserie turns is the same as a circular head movement. So in a circular head movement, we have tilted, contraction, tilted, extension, yeah? And in the circular head movement, my body is staying and my upper body is going around, jigga, 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 jigga. So now when we do the rotisserie turn, let's see, in a rotisserie turn, I'm also contraction. Now I keep this axis here, my roasted axis. I'm doing a quarter turn and I'm in my right tilt. Quarter turn, extension, quarter turn, left tilt, quarter turn, contraction. So this is very obvious, but the moment it got clear in my head, this distinction, it's actually the same movement, but this time my body is turning around my head, I opened a lot of new possibilities for myself, okay? So let's do this exercise once together, okay? So I'm staying sideways from the laptop, you can stay wherever you want. And we're going to start in the contraction, and I want you to pick a height that is comfortable for you. If you go very deep, it will be hard to maintain this. So maybe don't go as deep. And now that you're in your contraction, imagine here is your chicken stick. This is your axis, okay? So we're going to stay here. Now let's do a quarter turn to the left. Now you should be tilted towards your right. Check if your stick is still in the same place. And you have a tilt to the right now. Now let's do quarter turn to the left and you're in extension. Quarter turn to the left, you're in your side tilt, and quarter turn to the front and you're back where we started. Makes sense. Mm-hmm. Can you do this exercise one more time so just I can check your how it looks like with you? Very nice, you can do slowly. Yes, very nice, very nice, very nice. Okay, yes, looks good, looks good, looks good, looks good. Mm-hmm. Okay, very nice. So I've seen two things. I've seen two things that are very common and happens to me as well. Thing number one is usually what happens is that we stay quite deep in this position. This position is still easy. And then we come up in the extension. Do you see? If I do it maybe a little bit quicker, you will see I go down, come up, go down. Sometimes there's nothing we can do about it. And sometimes it doesn't even disturb as much. But if you can, try to avoid it. Try to stay on one level and either you can try to not go as deep in the beginning, or the other way, when you want to go deeper, you really need to work on your abdominals and on the opening of your chest. I would recommend not going as deep, maybe. And the other thing I saw with you, and happens to me as well, you will see it a lot in this class, I'm trying to work on this, but it's really hard, is doing this, I don't know how you call it in English, hyperextension here. Try to keep your hips in a neutral position, engage the abdominals, and try to really just open from your chest instead of doing this. You see, this might cause lower back pain. So really try to lift from here and then open from the chest in the extension. One more time with these tips, and then we're going to talk about the spins. You go your speed. You can also try to change the direction of the turn. We're turning to the left. Maybe you want to turn to the right. You can try if you want. Lisa, sehr gut. Versuch mal in der Contraction noch ein bisschen mehr die Knie zu beugen, wenn du kannst. Caro, sehr gut. Versuch in der Extension dran zu denken mit dem Hals, dass du da noch ein bisschen Platz hast. Natalia looks very nice. Try to keep your chest a little bit more open, the extension. I see you sometimes coming up a bit in the extension. Open the chest. Yes. And now try to stay where you are with your head. Yes, this. Very nice. Good. Okay, all good so far? Then let's talk about different possibilities for this turn. Just let me check with the time. I was a bit late for the class, so I'm going to do this class 10 minutes more than usually planned, okay? There's three possibilities for the turn. And the first one, we're going to touch it just briefly because I think it's going to be easy. So I think all of us, we're Zouk dancers. Let me see how you can see my feet. Okay. Let's do a normal left turn. I'm going to show you what I want you to do. Left turn would be to the left, back, step pivot to the front. Yeah, let's do this together. You have your left leg free. And we go left, back, step pivot. One side, step, and left turn. Left, back, step pivot. Okay. Now this is our normal left turn pattern. And we can use this for rotisserie turn. There is two rotisserie turns we can do. We can either do the dive or we can do the throw or lanzamento. For the dive, observe one time what we're going to do. The dive is called dive because we're putting our chest down and up. What I want you to do in the first step, I want you to open your right, close your left, so left tilt. Then on the second step, we're diving, we're putting our chest down, contraction. And on our third step, we're going to first open the right side and go straight up. Let me see, maybe you can see from this side a bit better. I'm going to show you left, contraction, and now I'm opening the left side and coming up here instead of from here straight up. I want you to first open the side and then come up. Si, señoras, let's try together. You have your left leg free and we're going step by step. So you tilt to your left on your left step. Now, contraction on your right step. And now while you're changing your way to the front, you're going to tilt to the right and open. One more time. We're going left, contraction, right and up. Last time, and then I'm going to check what you're doing. We go left, contraction, right and up. Okay, let me see what you're doing. Or do you have questions before? No? Okay, let's see. You can try in your speed. Caro, sehr schön. Aber Caro hat das ja auch schon, glaube ich, tausendmal mit mir gemacht. Ja, Lisa, sehr gut, super, genau. Natalia, go with your first step on your left.
It was easy to follow with Chris, but when I'm doing it by myself.
Yeah, true. But it's a very good practice to do it all by ourselves. Nice. Okay. Mm-hmm. So there's different arm styles. We're not going to talk too much about styling today because that's not the subject of the class, but you could either do the avion, what we just did, or you could do together and open, or you could also go around from the beginning, different options, okay? But let's talk about the flow, about the lanciamento now. Arm styling might be my next topic. Okay, let's talk about the lanciamento. What we did now for the dive, laptop issues. For the dive, we went down with our chest. Now what I want you to do, I want you to open the left. And then on the second step, we're going into extension. And then we're opening the right back to normal. I'm showing one more time. We're tilting to the right, opening the chest, tilting to the left, neutral. Once from this perspective, tilting to the right, up, left, neutral. Okay, let's do it together. You have your left leg free. Let's go slowly. You're tilting to your right while you're stepping to your left. Now, your second step, you're opening in the extension, chest up. Your head is pointing towards your leader. Now, while you're turning to your front leg, you're opening your right side, so tilt to the left and straight. So for this one, imagine, so for the other one, we were imagining like diving into the water. Now I want you to imagine you have a point here where your leader is. Maybe we can use our hands, okay? We're going to use our hands. I want you to dive underneath or lanciamento to be thrown underneath this point. So like mambo, mambo dance, mambo number 5. Yeah, Carol Granadas. Okay, let's do this together. I'm going to put my right hand in front. Maybe on like face, on the height of my face. Very good. And now you go to your left, tilt to the right. And now you have to dive underneath your arm. You're opening your chest, tilting to the left and straight. And last time, then I want you to see. I want to see you. 7, 8 and slow. And quick. Does this make sense? Lisa, willst du es nochmal sehen oder macht das Sinn? Gut? Geht so? Warte, ich zeig mal von dieser Seite. I'm going to show from this perspective. Maybe it's a little bit easier to see. When the leader is leading this movement, he's not giving you enough space to just turn upright. He's not giving you space. So what you have to do is you're going to... go underneath his hand. Okay, maybe this makes a little bit more sense. Sometimes they're leading it also on the elbow. Maybe you've seen this. Okay, try it out on your speed. Yeah, Lisa, das ging schon die richtige Richtung. And I'm going to try to see how I can help you. Genau, Lisa, verlager ruhig schon das Gewicht, während du die erste Bewegung machst. So, why are we doing the first step? We're doing the first tilt. So first tilt is with the first step, plus. And then I'm going into the next ones. It's much easier with a leader, much easier fluently, but who wants easy? No one wants easy. Natalia, this one was great. Yeah, Caro, sehr, sehr gut. Yeah, Lisa, sehr gut. Natalia and Lisa, maybe what you can do, I saw Caro doing it right now, and it makes a lot of sense. As soon as you're going to upright again, you can try to straighten your arm because that's where your leader is going to be. And this is also what your leader is going to do because afterwards you're maybe doing lateral, whatever, but straight to the front chest line. Because the leader is also going to put this arm down. Put it a bit more down. Let's see from this perspective. I'm going here and down. Yeah, Natalia, this, exactly. Ja, Lisa, genau das. Nur achten, dass du nicht zu sehr nach vorne kippst dann, ne? Versuch dann, dass du trotzdem gerade bleibst. Mein Arm kann ja sich auch strecken, ohne dass ich nach vorne kippe. Ja, sehr gut. Okay. We are good on this. Questions? Maybe, I don't know if it's still online, but you could try to check for the YouTube class from Thiago and me. We did a YouTube class, Dive and Throw. And there you can see how it looks like with a partner. And I think then you will recognize easier which movement I'm meaning in a couple of bands. I'm not 100% sure if it's still online, but you can try to check it, okay? So this is the typical movements we would start to introduce the rotisserie turn. Because what we did right now in the dive and in the lanzamento is just half of the turn. So in the dive, we did this half, the lower half. And in the lanzamento and the throw, we did this half. Okay, so like you can imagine, it's a circle and we first dive, lanzamento. Dive, lanzamento. Make sense? And now we're going to combine it. Now we're really going into the roasted chicken. And here we're going to talk a lot more about spinning technique again. Do you remember, maybe if you have been in this class, if not, no worries, the class with paddling technique. I don't know if any of you have been in this class. The paddling spins, the paddling technique means basically you have one standing leg and the other one is paddling around, okay? What you want to do, you want to keep your axis here instead of going back and forth. So we don't want to do this like a dancing teddy. We want to keep our axis here on one leg and the other one is going around. And try to make sure to keep your turnout with your legs. Yeah. So what we practice having an object in front of our heels and then we were pushing this object because we want to keep the turnout in the standing leg. So this was the theory in two sentences from the paddling spin. And we're going to use this paddling spin technique now combined with our roasted chicken technique, okay? If we want to do more than one spin on a spot without using one foot spin, because one foot spin with roasted chicken, it's possible, but it's very advanced. I'm still trying to figure that one out. So it's really hard. What we're going to do instead is the paddling spin. Whenever you're going to be spin in one place, then you're going to do paddling spin to start with. We're going to imagine, let me see which side is best for you. Maybe this side. I'm going to imagine here in front is my chicken stick. And now I'm turning to my left, which means if I'm turning to my left, I'm using my left leg as standing leg and my right leg, I'm going to put it first on the right, on the left, on the right, on the left, on the right, on the left, while I'm doing the rotisserie turn. Okay, ugh, hair everywhere. Let's try to do it together. So you are in this contracted position and now where your head is needs to stay your axis, okay? You're standing on your left. Now your right leg is on your right side and you're going through, tilt, into extension. Now your right leg is on your right side and you're pushing with the right again, contraction. Push with the right, 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 DDDD. Reach into a contraction, come up, breathe. Oof. Let's use our arms for help, okay? What I'm going to do with the arms, I'm going to do a, well, it's not a ballet position, it's a little bit higher than a ballet position, like in front of my chest. And I'm trying to bring out my elbows. This will help me to keep this axis, okay? Let's try this and let me have a look what you're doing. Try to remember about your standing leg. It needs to stay externally rotated. Caro, pass auf, dass die Schultern nicht hoch an deine Ohren kommen, vor allem in der Contraction. Sonst die Arme lieber ein bisschen tiefer halten, bevor die Schultern hochkommen. Ja. Ja, Lisa sieht sehr gut aus. Mhm. Yes, looks good, Natalia. Very good. Okay. And come up. Very good. Now, let's talk about spotting. There is, as far as I know, three possibilities how to spot in this kind of turns. One that I use a little bit more if I really have a leader and if I'm still not sure what he's going to do. If I'm not sure if he's going to do just one rotisserie turn and then he's going to keep on doing circling and then whatever else. In this case, I'm spotting my hand because usually when I spot my hand, I will not miss the leading. Let's say he's doing one rotisserie turn and then he's going to circle a head movement and then he's going to tilt a turn. If I spot my hand, I will not miss whatever he's going to lead. So let's train this first. It's not the best option in our case, but for what I just said, if you don't know what the leader is doing, it's a good option. So you're going into this ballet-ish handhold and you're spotting your own hand while you do the rotisserie turn on the spot. Let me see what you're doing. Mm-hmm. Gatsby, be careful about not going, what I see right now, here you're fine, and then you're going way up and down and up and down. This will not help you with your balance. Try to stay more or less on one level, if possible, more or less. And try to be sure where your axis is. Your axis is where the crown of your head is. Lisa, pass auf, dass dir die Schultern nicht hochkommen in der Extension bei dir. Genau, ja. Yeah, very good. Natalia, you're sometimes wobbling a little bit with your axis. Let's see what I'm seeing. So the height of your axis is nice, but what I'm seeing now is that your axis sometimes is like shifting from here to there. So try to really keep it in one spot. Last time, and then we're going to go to the second option for spotting. Wenn euch schwindelig ist, Caro, dann macht ruhig eine Pause, ne? Or what you can also do, you can also try to turn to the other side, to the right side. Okay, let's talk about the next possibility for spotting. So what I just told you, it's a possible option, but I think it's not the best against dizziness. So what I prefer to do for dizziness on a rotisserie turn, if the turn is going slow, then I'm doing this. If the turn is going slow, I'm first spotting the ground and then I'm spotting up and down and up and down. Okay, let's try this. I'm spotting the ground as long as possible. And just when I'm around, so I'm moving my upper body first and then I'm moving my head. Upper body, head. For spotting, down and up. Let's try that. If you want to turn to the right side, feel free to do so. Because we're actually right now turning to the left. Maybe let's all together to the right, just to make one thing clear. If you want to turn to the right side, I need my right leg now to stay in the same position and my left leg is turning around. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Nice, very good. Okay. Mm-hmm. Good. So this spotting, I use it for slow turns. If the leader is doing the turns a little bit quicker, there is another option that's my favorite one. I like to do spotting just on one spot. So if I have the possibility, if the leader is doing the spin fast enough, I try to only spot the ground. It helps me even more with the dizziness and it looks cooler. So I'm just spotting the ground, and then I keep my head there as long as possible. I'm moving the upper body, and then I'm trying to go down again. Let's try to see it a little bit quicker. So this gets us a little 3D effect. Yeah? Let's try this one and try to keep spotting down. So I'm first moving my chest as far as I can. Then I can't move anymore. I'm first using my head and then the rest of my body. Oops. It's a little bit hard. I'm having concrete floor, but yeah, I'm trying my best. Okay. Let's see what you're doing. Try to spot the floor. Maybe you need to do the turns a little bit quicker. Yeah. Yes. Wow, this looks really nice. Caro, der sieht traumhaft aus. Yes, I think for Natalia, this one is easier as well, isn't it? Yeah. Yeah. Dieser trau dich sonst im Zweifelsfall. Ja, genau, dass du die Drehung grundsätzlich eher flott machst, aber so sah schon gut aus. If you need a break, take a break. Eh? Ja, Lisa, das war supi. Yes, 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 yes. We're getting there. We're getting there. Nice. Okay. We're getting there. Okay. Last thing about the spot, well, about turning in one spot with the rotisserie turn is about the paddling leg. So the paddling leg is the one that's traveling around. This is my paddling leg, yeah? A lot of times I get asked, how many steps do you do? How often do you use your leg? And this does really depend on your balance and on the speed of the spin. So if my balance is not as good, I'm very probably going to use the paddling leg more often. So right now we practice on the right, on the left, on the right. But let's say your balance is not very good that day, for whatever reason. You didn't sleep enough, you have concrete floor like I have. Then you can also use the leg on the side, in the front, on the side, on the back, on the side, front, so four spots. It's possible, why not? If that helps you, it's possible. I usually do what I told you on the one side, on the other side, and one side. But if my balance is not very good, I would use it more often. And then there's the other case. Let's say today you have a marvelous day. Your floor is amazing, your leader is amazing, and the spin is a little bit faster. In this case, I'm not sure if I can do it here, but if the spin is going quite fast, sometimes I'm just putting my leg in front, do the full turn and on front again. Maybe you can see from this side, especially when I'm using the spotting on the ground. This is my favorite technique, spotting on the ground and using the leg just in front, full turn just in front. Okay. Ooh. Yeah, maybe let's try the different options together. Let's try four spots. So we're already here. Let's use our leg on the side, in the front, on the side, in the back, side, front, and so on. Quite easy, I think. Okay, it's quite easy like this, yeah? Now let's try the other extreme. Let's try putting the leg only in front. Okay, we're going into the contracted position and our paddling leg is already in front. We're spotting the floor and we're doing quick turns. And turn, front, turn, front, and turn, front. And obviously we would try to do continuous turns, but I think without a leader, this one is very hard. Yes, looks really nice. Yeah. Session, session, session. Very nice, Natalia. Very nice. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, questions until here. Okay. Is it okay if I take the last 5 more minutes? Is that okay for everyone? Yes. Good, good. If not, you can also leave and then watch the video later. It's also no problem. Okay. So in the last 5 minutes, let's talk about traveling spins with rotisserie turn. You know already everything you need to know. We're just going to combine everything. So we did rotisserie on the spot. Now the leader could definitely also do a rotisserie turn, but traveling, 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 and I'm out of laptop. So the technique that I usually use is the same that I taught you as a second position. So second position, second position, second position, and so on. So I'm moving my legs according to my hips, according to my upper body, everything en bloc. Let's try turning towards the left as a traveling spin. So rotisserie, we're in contracted position. Now we're turning towards our left on a line. I'm going into extension, contraction, extension, contraction, but I'm turning on a line. Yes, very good. And from here, you can obviously also turn back towards the right. Tick, 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 always in the second position. Yeah, super, super, super. Wow, I think this is easier for you than the other one, isn't it? I think it's harder, but obviously for you, it seems to be easier. But we just practiced so much, it seems easier. Just maybe one thing right now, just to practice what we did right now, was going from contraction to extension, contraction, extension. Later, obviously you want the whole movement to be fluent and to produce this circle. So we're going to practice one more round, a little bit more fluently. And I want you to think also about this tilted part. It's a short part only, but it makes the whole movement look round, more round. So while I'm transferring the weight, I have to pass this tilted moment to go into the extension, tilt again to go into contraction. So we really have this circular movement. Okay, let's try it one time. Maybe do one line to the right and one line to the left. Ja, Caro, sehr gut. Pass auf, dass die Schultern nicht zu sehr an die Ohren kommen, wenn du in der Extension bist. Genau das, ja. Supi. Ja, sehr gut, Lisa. Natalia, try to move everything on block. For this exercise, we like really using the leg together with, I'm using the leg together with my upper body. I'm not putting the leg first and turning down. Lisa, was bei dir, glaube ich, manchmal, also erstmal, ich lasse Caro erstmal die Frage stellen und dann sage ich was zu dir.
I have one question. When you have some kind of a ballon here and you do it with contraction and when you're up, is it possible or just logical that your hands are a little bit more apart when you are up because you open the chest and down you close the chest? Yeah.
I've never thought so much about it actually, but now that you're saying it, it makes sense. So I think so, yes.
Okay.
And also, I'm not going 100% up and down because I'm turning diagonal. So this is my axis. My axis is not here.
Yes.
It's a little bit more diagonal. So here, my arms are...
Yes, it's fully diagonal, not like this.
Exactly. It's diagonal. Very good question. Lisa, was ich bei dir... Danke, Caro. Sehr gute Frage. Lisa, was ich bei dir eben manchmal gesehen habe, du hast so manchmal das Gleichgewicht ein bisschen verloren, wenn du zu groß hier unten warst. Dann versuch hier ein bisschen dich zurückzunehmen, damit du nicht zu weit weg bist von deiner Achse. Macht das Sinn?
Ja, danke, genau. Ja, das probiere ich. Ja. Mhm.
Das war auch immer genau meine Problemstelle. Ich war auch immer genau, auch heutzutage, wenn ich umfliege, ist fast immer, weil ich hier zu groß bin. Okay. Last technique and you're done. Obviously, this all takes practice and so on, but just I give you a lot of information and you do whatever you want with this information. So what we just did was turning always in the second position. Now there is one other possibility, but this possibility, I can only use it, the second one I'm going to teach you now, if I already know, I already understood, okay, the leader is going to do traveling spins in a line. If I'm unsure, I prefer this. But if I know, okay, this is a traveling spin in the line, he's leading it already for the third time, then I'm going to do to the front the same thing, front turn the same. But now for the back turn, I'm first putting my leg, crossing, and then turning. Front, cross, and turn. Yeah, are we all on the same page with what is front turn, what is back turn? Front turn would be if I'm turning to my left, the first step, and now if I'm turning back, cross the leg. Let's do it together, maybe. Let's all turn towards the left. You are in your contracted position. You have your right leg free. Let's do the first half turn. En bloc, first half turn. Now you're crossing your left first and then turning around. Achoo, sorry. Your right leg is going en bloc, your left leg cross and turn. Let me see what you're doing. Ja, sieht super aus, Caro. Ja, Lisa, ich glaube, das ist einfacher für dich, richtig? Oder es ist die Sache, dass du die Front ein bisschen kleiner machst. Eins von beidem, aber das sieht super aus. Ja. Natalia, but still keep doing a turn on line. So you still have to, you're crossing one and then you're stepping the next one. You go into a decontraction. Now turn and now transfer your weight to the right. And let's do one more time together. Okay, let's do it together, Natalia. Or maybe let's do without the head, just the legs, okay? Just the legs. The right is free, I'm turning half turn. Now I'm crossing with my leg and turn. Still have to go in line. Half turn, cross, turn. And then you can combine with the head. Yeah, half turn. Yes, yes, this one, yes. Very good. And obviously you can try to the right as well. Huh? So I can obviously also turn to the right. So then I would use the left on block, the right cross and turn. Left, left on block. I'm lost, sorry. I never turn to the right. Half turn, cross and turn. And half turn, cross, half turn. So you see, this is my personal exercise. Whenever I train with the boys and they're getting really creative, Justus, for example, is going super creative. And whenever he is doing traveling spins, rotisserie on the right, I'm super lost because this almost never happens on Zug. Do you have questions? I hope I didn't rush too much, but my idea is always to give you the exercises and the information and you can train how much you want or not want. Okay, so this is officially the last class from the spinning technique. If there is some technique you want to do more classes about, you can tell me. For example, I don't know, one foot spins or I don't know, head movements, whatever you want. I'm going to write each of you. If you have any feedback, I'm always open to it. And for the next classes, I'm just going to tell you my ideas. And then you are free to participate or not. My ideas would be either a lady styling routine where we use all these techniques we just learned in the last weeks and we use them together in a routine just to have some fun and play around and train a bit the techniques. Another idea would be body isolations and body waves, a little bit more into detail. Another possibility would be head movements again, but I think most of you already did head movements, but we could go a bit more into detail. Let me check if I have more ideas. Or if you want to do something specific, I'm also happy to do that. Let me see, followers, choreography, isolations and waves. Ah, another idea would be doing arm movements. Yeah, so I think that's basically the ideas. And you tell me what you want to do. Thank you very much for participating. This is always my favorite part of the week, doing these classes together with you. So thank you very much. Everything will be uploaded. If you want to rewatch any class, tell me. Everything is on YouTube. And thank you very much. Have a nice evening.
Danke auch.
Danke euch. Sehr schön, dass du dabei warst.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.